anyway, guys, before my dad starts this video, don't forget to smash that like button
and subscribe
and hit that notification bell
so that way you can be notified to see the new video.
Boy, Kerry, too smooth. If you're brand new to this channel, go ahead and subscribe. Click the bell to be notified every time we drop some new videos. So today I want to talk about this Mary J. Blige song. It's a little bit older, but it's a really cool song that you as a guitar player, because I've been getting a lot of questions, like how do you play R&B when there's no guitar in the chords or there's no guitar in the track? Like, what do you do? So I want to take this concept and I want to show you. Essentially, you're picking out the notes. You're going to hear the notes in the progression, but you got to play the chords that go accordingly to the song. So the song we're using today is Lost Without You by Mary J. Blige. So I wanted you to take a listen to the song, and then we're going to go back and we're going to break it down. So the song is in the key of F sharp major. So let's just take a listen to the song real quick. So in situations where there is no guitar, you want to listen for that bass notes. Let the bass notes kind of lead you to where you're supposed to be going in this song. So I listened to the bass notes, and this is the concept that I came up with. These are the progressions that I came up with. This is the progression that I came with. So I'm playing an F sharp major. So I'm hearing that six. Now again, if you're not familiar with the number system, I highly encourage you to go to kerryscamp.com and really start to immerse yourself in the number system, because from time to time, I will call out a number. I won't necessarily say the chord, but I'll say the number when I'm referring to what I'm playing in the progression. So I'm saying the six, which is that E flat minor seven. Okay, then we're gonna go to that four, which is that B flat major seven. We're gonna go to that five, which is gonna be that C sharp major seven. A flat major minor seven. We're gonna go to that B minor seven. So it's a... Now, as a guitarist, what I like to do, I like to try to add a little bit of flavor and flair in what I'm doing. I don't want to just sit and just play the progression and that's it. I like to add a little something, like a little passing note. Now, if you don't want to add any passing notes, you don't have to do it. But it's just something that, you know, as a guitarist, I like to add just a little something in there so when people hear it, they're like, ooh! But you don't have to do it. If you don't hear it in the song, you don't have to do it. It's just something that you can do as a guitarist to add a little bit of flavor to your playing. So this is the idea and the concept that I want to add to it. I want to add a diminished chord, okay? So I'm looking at the six, four, five, two, three. And between the five and the six, I want to do that diminished, that D diminished seven. Single time, but in the concept, when I'm learning a new concept, I want to keep recycling or keep looping that situation so I have it underneath my hands. I'm developing that muscle memory so the way that I have it the way that I want it. So just to recap again, this song is called Without You. It's by Mary J. Blige. I'll just make sure I'm saying it right. Be Without You, that's the name of the song. It's called Be Without You. It's by Mary J. Blige. You can play it. Again, I did this song and I chose this song because there's so many times that I see people leave comments like, how do you play a song when there's no guitar in the track? So I chose this song specifically because there is no guitar in this track. Again, the song is in the key of F sharp major. If you're not familiar with the numbers, you hear me yell out the numbers, I highly suggest you going to kerryscamp.com and checking out the course on the number system, because it's like the universal language of how we speak music. A lot of times, because you can't just yell across the stage, hey, blah, 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 play an A flat minor, whatever. You might just say, go to the six, or go to the four, go to the three. You'll understand what those numbers mean. It won't feel like, what is he talking about? I understand that concept. So, To jump back into the lesson before I pass it to you guys and let you guys work this thing out. We're doing that E flat minor 7, which is at 6. We're going to go to that 4, which is at B major 7. That 5, which is going to be the C sharp major 7. That 2, which is going to be A flat. Back to that B minor. B flat minor. So. Just for a little bit of sauce, just that, like, kind of switch it up a little bit, add a little, so we're not just hanging on the chord. If you want to do it, you don't have to do it. Is that D major diminished 7, D diminished 7. So that's the concept behind it. Just like I said again, it's just one of these things that I encourage you to watch the video all the way through, go back in and take some notes, and then rewatch it again to get something with your hand. This is really just for you to develop how your ear, your hand, your muscle memory, keep looping it until you get it, and that way you can play it from your heart instead of playing